Elon Musk just exposed a top-secret mission between Russia and China. Chinese presentations at the International Astronautical Congress, or IAC, in Paris without China's name on them, may have been the most subduedly assertive manner for China to communicate problems with its space cooperation with Russia. In an effort to compete with the U.S. in the new era of space exploration, China wants to conduct 3 unmanned missions to the moon over the next 10 years. But China just ditched Russia in the supposed partnership to conquer the far side of the moon. What happened exactly? Let us find out, because Elon Musk will update us all. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multibillion-dollar companies, space news, and the latest science and technology. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of our amazing videos. And let's get started. According to Space News, at the IAC in Paris last week, China advertised that it was looking for new international partners while omitting mention of main partner Russia, with the country's chief space representative informing the gathered experts that the nation is open to receiving international proposals for its Chang'e 7 lander and orbiter mission. Oops. According to Musk, the Chinese National Space Administration, or CNSA, and other Chinese organizations were extremely active at the International Astronautical Congress, which recently ended in Paris. To help it on its upcoming endeavors, the Celestial Empire is seeking allies. The missions Chang'e 7, which will set down at the moon's south pole, and Chang'e 8, which will attempt to mine the moon's surface, are at the focus of most of the attention. China provides space on these devices for rent to other nations so they can use it for their own research apparatus. The forthcoming Chang'e 6 mission will already carry a Pakistani CubeSat, an Italian retroreflector, a Swedish negative ion detector, a French radon detector, and a retroreflector. Additionally, it will house a 10-kilogram rover from Saudi Arabia. For its deep space exploration missions, China is additionally seeking collaborators. In 2025, the spacecraft Tianwen-2 will attempt to collect samples from a close-by asteroid. Mars will be visited by Tianwen-3, and Jupiter and Uranus will be visited by Tianwen-4. The Celestial Empire still has a place on all these gadgets for nations who want to join it as allies. China's Lunar Base, which will be launched in the late 2030s in the south pole of our moon, is the project that is now promoting the most. It is promoted as a venue for global collaboration by the Celestial Empire. However, it makes an effort to remain anonymous while referring to its principal project partner. The Russian Federation and the PRC on equal rights served as the project's co-founders, according to a roadmap that was inked for it in St. Petersburg back in the summer of 2021. But for some reason, this year, China comments on the PowerPoint slides that were being used in the presentations at the time with the phrase, "The program was launched in China in 2014. Of course, the conflict that Russia has sparked against Ukraine is the primary cause of such an odd transformation. Any future collaboration with the aggressor nation is now toxic. The only thing that is still unknown is the reason for China's reticence over its most recent partner. There has long been awareness that there is no friendship between the two nations. Only technological advancements and industrial infrastructures are of interest to the Celestial Empire. Unknown is whether they actually placed a cross on a nation that hasn't been able to launch anything significantly new into space in a while and is looking for new allies. The lunar base may wind up continuing to be their shared undertaking in the end. We are obviously reading tea leaves in this situation, Musk stated. The exclusion is startling, though, considering China and Russia inked a cooperation agreement in March 2021 to jointly construct the International Lunar Research Station, or ILRS. Similar to NASA's long-delayed Artemis mission, this one aspires to establish a base close to the south pole of the moon. According to timelines provided by the China National Space Administration, the countries are now engaged in the reconnaissance stage of the project, which aims to host crewed lunar trips by the middle of the 2030s. Any communist nation must have central planning, notwithstanding the history of its inconsequential results. Everywhere in the government, bureaucrats are periodically entrusted with creating objectives and benchmarks for their particular area of responsibility as part of that planning. The CNSA published one of those earlier this year. These often take the shape of a 5 or 10 year plan, Musk explained. This report is the 5th of its kind. The first 4 were published in 2000, 2006, and 2011, and the most recent one was published in 2016. The present plans for further space exploration build on the previous ones. Although the text is lengthy at almost 7,500 words, it nonetheless provides a relatively high-level summary of the objectives of the organization. A few key areas of focus are enhancing the sustainability of their rocket launches, enhancing their global positioning system, collaborating with Russia on lunar exploration, maintaining and expanding the Tiangong space station, looking into the underlying technology for a Mars sample return mission, and forming an international alliance to construct a research station on the moon. China's workhorse rocket, the Long March, should experience an environmental improvement over the next 5 years, becoming pollution-free in a short period of time. Additionally, according to the white paper, CNSA intends to create a second fleet of rockets that can meet the increasing demand for regular launches. In this, reusable components and re-entry capable upper stages would be included. Any global positioning system must launch above the atmosphere, and CNSA aims to make significant advancements in this area during the next 5 years. CNSA's response to GPS is called Beidou, which consists of satellites for environmental monitoring and remote sensing. The five-year plan encompasses enhancements to location precision and the installation of communication relays. However, there are plans to launch the Shunxian telescope in the next 5 years, which will have capabilities roughly comparable to those of Hubble, ensuring that peer scientific satellites won't be left behind. The pursuit of science will not be restricted to outer space. With Chang'e 6, 7, and 8 under development and scheduled to launch within the next 5 years, China will have plenty of opportunities to explore the moon in the future. CNSA intends to perform another lunar return sample mission and conduct study on the lunar polar regions by hopping around them. In the upcoming years, CNSA intend to develop a wide range of lunar capabilities. But other scientific projects, like the Tiangong space station's ongoing expansion, might be undertaken independently by it. The Wentian and Mingtian laboratory cabin modules will be joined by the Tianhe core module during the following 5 years, after the Tianhe core module's successful debut in April of last year. The agency's operations during the following 5 years will be heavily reliant on increasing the station's capabilities, but the white paper oddly lacks specific explanations of what they will do with it. According to Musk, China's goal to continue and improve its capability to explore Mars is quite clearly outlined in the white paper. CNSA intends to expand deep space communications and build the underlying technologies for a sample return trip as part of its five-year strategy to increase its infrastructure's capacity to handle missions near Mars. That most likely won't launch in the next 5 years, but even with that schedule, it may potentially be vying with NASA's Mars sample return mission in a race to bring the first material back to Earth from Mars. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click on the like button and make sure you share it with your friends and family. And if you have any questions or comments for us, as always, please share them with us in the comment space below. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, where you'll see even more of our incredible videos. And you can also check out our other videos that have been specially selected just for you. Make sure you press that bell icon and you will be notified immediately of all of our latest uploads. Thanks for spending time with us today, and we look forward to doing it again soon. Have a great rest of your day, and thanks for watching.